Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. We're going to be starting a Cognitive Labs in Action session. Today, I'm going to be talking about a specific new lab that's available today in preview called Project Personality Chat. It's in the conversational AI space. So I'm going to walk you through a couple of demos and just show you how this really cool tech works. Before we dive in, I'm just going to show you a quick, this is a full summary of all the other similar talks that you might be interested in. It's in the conversational AI space. And most of these, all of these are after this talk, so make sure you catch these as well. All right, so let's dive in. Let's talk about bots today for a second, right? So bots today are really great, as you've seen, at doing processes, answering FAQ kind of situations. But then what we've done with Personality Chat is improve that, enhance that by adding the ability to answer small talk or chit-chat. And that's what Personality Chat does. So what does that mean? It enhances your bot's conversational capabilities by handling small talk, and more importantly, doing this in a way that's in line and consistent with your bot's personality specifically. So let me give you an example of how that would look. Let's say when you're in a bot that's a bank bot that's talking about questions about how do I get my login information, stuff like that. In that flow, users tend to go a little bit out of the bot flow and go slightly on a tangent by saying things like, thank you, that was helpful. And it's a nice conversation. They're trying to interact with the bot. At this point, if you're able to handle that well and in line with the bot's voice or the brand voice, it creates a really great end-to-end user experience. And so personality is one of those ways where you can create a good user engagement story for your bot specifically. Without having to worry about writing for it or thinking about persona, we give you that right off the bat. So there's a couple of different endpoints of how you use it. So how exactly will you use it for your bot today? I'm going to show you two ways or two endpoints in which you can interact with this. The first is through the Bot Builder SDK. This is an editorial-only response library. So there's a list of responses that are handcrafted and curated for certain default personas. And you can easily integrate with that today by calling our NuGet package. And I'll show you how to do that. The second piece that we do have is the Cognitive Services Labs page. So I think you guys just saw like the Cognitive Labs page and the Services page. So you can go head over there and try out our Personality Chat demo today. That's available as a demo. And that includes both the editorial piece I just talked about, as well as dynamically generated responses. And these are generated using deep neural networks. So I'll show you how that's done as well as a quick demo. And you can try it out today, like right after this talk, maybe. So let's first dig into the editorial library. So today, we have about more than 100 common small talk scenarios that are answered today. They've already been handcrafted. They're ready for you to put into your bot right now. And that should capture like 90% of the kind of chit-chat that people do today with bots. We have this available for three different personas. Professional, which is much more buttoned up and formal. Let's say you're doing a bank bot, something like that. Friendly, which is somewhere in the middle. And then right down to humorous, which is much more casual, fun, friendly bot, which let's say you're doing, you know, a weather bot that's sassy or like fun or witty, then you might want to use that bot, that persona. How do these look different? I'll show you a quick sample. Some scenarios, like the common scenarios, like thank you. You see a slight tone difference between you're quite welcome and you bet. But then if you try and go a little bit off tangent a little bit and ask stuff like, will you marry me? The professional bot is still all professional, and it says, no, no, let's stick to the professional relationship. But the humorous bot says, sure, take me to City Hall. We'll see what happens. Right? So you see that as you're chatting with it, the persona sort of comes out a little more. And I'll show you a quick demo as well. So how do you get this awesome goodness in your bot today? There's three ways you can do this. If you're using the Bot Builder SDK v4, which people have been demoing today, then you can see that you have your bot's middleware. All you have to do is add the Personality Chat middleware to your bot's middleware. And I'll show you the exact code that you need to add. It's like four lines of code, super simple. Just add it to your bot's middleware. In case you're using a Q&A Maker bot, just like the ones Giampaolo and Paul were demoing earlier, if you saw, if you're using Q&A Maker already and you don't want to call our NuGet package and call our API specifically, the entire editorial data set is available publicly. You can just import that, add it to your Q&A Maker bot as another knowledge base, and you don't even need to call our package. If you're using Bot Builder SDK v3, there is a personality chat dialogue that you just need to add to your bot's base dialogue and just inherit that. And it's, again, available, super simple to use. We'll share most all of these links as well in documentation, so you can go ahead and get started. Just like I said, I'll show you, this is a quick example of in the SDK v4, how exactly you will include it. So you include the package right on top, the personality chat NuGet package. Then in the middleware, you just add the personality chat middleware. There's a few things that you can do to customize it a little bit. So if you say respond only if chat is true, it means that we have our chat classifier, which is like a deep learned, you know, query understanding model. So it checks to see if the query given is a chit chat or a small talk query, and only responds if it is a chit chat or small talk query. So this prevents this from interrupting, let's say, task flows or information flows. The second we just talked about, which is the persona setting. We have three personas today. You can set it to humorous, professional, or friendly. The score threshold just gives you a threshold on, we return a score along with every response we give you. So you can choose the threshold depending on how precise or how much recall you want. So the higher the score, the more the precision will be, but you might lose out on recall. So you can choose what is more suitable for your bot if you don't want it to be too chatty. I'm going to quickly switch to demo and show you how this really works. And hopefully the monitor switch should work. Oh. All right. OK. Thanks. So this is, we created a sample weather bot and put two personas on it, again, using the same code that I just showed you. So this is the humorous weather bot. So it says, hi, I'll be a weatherman. So I'm just going to type and say hiya. And let's see what it says. It says, what's cooking? That's personality for you right off the bat. I'm going to ask it what the weather is, because that's the sample task that we've trained it to do for now. And so even if you can see, the weather bot itself has some personality in it. So I'm going to respond to what it just says and say, I am not silly. And it says, alert the media. Whoa. So it's all of this is coming, again, from our editorially curated set. So I can also continue and respond and say, ha ha, very funny, and it'll continue, right? And so you see that this is the tone of the humorous bot. Similarly, we can have a very similar conversation with the professional bot that I just talked about, where if I say hi, it's a lot more formal. It's a lot more to the point. But it will still respond to all of it. It says, what can I do for you? And I say, what's the weather? So it just gives me the weather without too much personality associated with it. And I say, thank you. And it responds to that. Again, the flow continues. Let's give it another example so you can see how much depth the editorial has. Like I said, 100 plus scenarios. So it covers quite a huge amount of the head queries. So when I say, who made you? It says, tech people. Let's ask, do you like them? And so here's where you start seeing the edges of, you know, how much curated data can do. Because it really does respond. It understands you're asking for an opinion. It says, I really couldn't say, because it doesn't understand exactly what opinion you're asking from it. So it tries to do sort of like a dodge. And then I can continue saying, why not? And it loses. Because you can't have too much of a long conversation with just editorial, right? This is where the second piece comes in. I'm just going to quickly switch back to my presentation. So the second piece, which is the Cognitive Services Labs piece. So today, if you go to Cognitive Services Labs page, which is labs.cognitive.microsoft.com, you'll see Project Personality Chat. You can click on that. It takes you to a demo page, which I'll open in a moment. On the demo page, you can just chat with the bot. You can choose a persona and see what responses come up based on the persona. Again, this is real-time generated responses, not editorial responses. And it gives you those responses along with the scores of how it calculates these responses. So in the future, so today we have it as a demo, just, you know, as we're scaling out. There's a way for you to contact us to get early access of the API once we have it. Let me take a few seconds to talk about what is response generation. So how are responses generated today? So Personality Chat uses a sequence-to-sequence LSTM model. So it's using DNNs, specifically an LSTM model. It's trained on large volumes of speaker conversational data. And every time you give it a new query, it has learned and has a vocabulary that's available for it. So it's learned typical conversational patterns. So now when you say, how are you? It looks at its vocabulary, and tries to pick word by word what the next response should be. And it's picking the words based on a probability distribution given that particular query, right? So that's how it generates it each time. So no matter what you change a comma, the way you phrase it, the response could be totally different. So this is how the response generation in general works. So where does personality come in here? So personality comes in the way we've trained the model. When we train the model, we have different speakers in the training model, which are each represented as a vector in the vector space. Now we take all the different speakers and try to cluster the ones that are very similar, that speak using similar phrases, use similar words, and cluster them in that vector space. So each speaker now becomes one persona, right? Once we have a persona, we define the characteristics of that persona depending on how those people in that cluster behave. So let's again talk about how response generation works without the speaker, right? Without the persona ID. So normally when you say, are you really smart? It looks in the vocabulary that it has and tries to generate words one by one using a certain distribution for those words. Now you'll add persona ID, like I said here, will be added as an input in your decoder model. And so that affects the probability distribution of the words itself. So basically what that does is it gives higher weight for words and patterns that are similar to the ones in that persona space. Right? And you can come talk to us later even for more details. On the page itself, the documentation gives you references to the papers that talk about these methods. And that's what we have today. In the future, you can see how, so today we have default personas. You can see how in the future, you can come and say, I want it to talk like this. And we can try to find the closest cluster or even retrain the model based on what you want to do. So you can take a model, retrain it if needed in the future. So today we have defaults, but we can very easily scale into having it talk really like a specific kind of person or persona for your bot. All right, I'm going to quickly switch to a demo of how this really works. All right. Like I said, you go to the Microsoft Cognitive Services page. On that homepage, you see Project Personality Chat, and it tells you a little bit about it. An important thing to note is because we want to stay focused on this message of only answering chit-chat, even though the model can answer a lot of other intents and domains, we are trying to make it focus only on specific small talk intents so it doesn't derail your business bot conversation. So let's try the similar, let's try friendly this time because we tried the other two. I'm going to do the same conversation we started with the weather bot saying, who made you? And so it says lots and lots of people. And so this is slightly different from the other responses we got. So let's ask this time, do you like these people? And it says, yes, I do. This is generated on the fly, like I said, auto-generated responses. And you can see immediately why it's there is a value prop here, because editorial could never be this specific. This is able to be super specific and says, yes, I do. They're very nice people, and it's friendly, right? And so you can also see here in this side the other responses, the other top responses that could have come up. Like, I don't mind them. Yeah, I like them. Yeah, I love them. Of course I do. And so you can see the kind of things that this bot would say. Let's continue and say why, because this is another thing that, context is hard to do with editorial. So this model, so it says, yeah, because they're very nice people. So it keeps one turn plus of context specifically. So usually context doesn't matter too much, but if you give a query which is of low information, like why, it takes a lot of the information from the previous context. And it says, because they're nice people. We can even continue and say, do you hang out with them? And says, no, I don't hang. Again, you can see how specific it's being while still staying true to the persona and not saying, not going into smileys. And I'll show you the other persona so you can see the difference. And so it doesn't hang out with us. Why not? I don't know. I just don't see them, right? So you can actually continue as long as you're still doing small talk and chit chat and not trying to ask for information. It will continue most of the time. So that's the friendly. I can also take a second and talk. Let's talk to the professional part for a second and just say, hi, how are you? And again, this is coming from the auto-generated. It says, fine, thanks, how are you? Again, you can see the tone being very, very professional and formal. So I'm going to say, I'm good. Excited to be here. It says, me too. I hope you have a great time. Right? So you can see it's actually trying to understand and continue. Let's ask it about the conference. Do you like being at the conference? It says, yes, it's a great conference. Not plugging for build, but it says it's a great conference, right? So you can see how it's able to do this in that tone versus the same humorous part would be slightly different. And you see it's starting to use smileys, which the other bot was not using. Do you like being at the conference? Right, so you can see the tone being very different. And feel free to go ahead and like try this out. Check out the demo. I will share the page in just a second. So hang on, let it switch back. So yeah, so this is like a lot of things that you can check out in this space. The one that I've highlighted, aka.ms/personalitychat, will lead you to the demo that I just described. And you can see in the documentation there will be references to papers as well. I'm going to end it now. I think we have a few minutes for Q&A, and I want to call out to my awesome team here. Please feel free to come ask us questions if you don't have time now, but after as well. So, all right, thanks, guys.